Welcome to ECE 461-661 Control Systems. I'm Jake Lauer, and in this lecture, we'll be giving an overview of the course, as well as the syllabus. Now, before we do that, let's talk about what control systems are. Now, controls is kind of a generic term. It can mean many things. One of the things it means is process control. Here, think a car wash. When you bring your car into a car wash, I wait until an event happens, like you pull your car forward, then a pump turns on, water turns on, turns off, you know, things basically turn on and off at different times. One way to implement that is a programmable logic controller, PLC. Another definition of controls is applied math. If you have a dynamic system, like a bicycle, airplane, things like that, those are all dynamic systems. How do you control the output? Keep an airplane flying level, keep the bicycle upright, using feedback. So controls also means the analysis of feedback control systems. How to design a compensator to make the system behave better and improve the response. So feedback in general is all important. The purpose of feedback is to make the output a function of the input. And you kind of have that with your car. I can sit there and adjust the accelerator by myself, or I can use the cruise control. The cruise control uses feedback. It compares the actual car speed to the set speed and automatically adjusts the input to set the output. Now, feedback is all important. With feedback, you can improve the response of a dynamic system. You can even stabilize unstable systems. Now, that's really important. Most systems in the real world are unstable. That's really how the real world works with feedback. For example, the Federal Reserve, its job is to control the inflation rate to about 2%, and it does that by adjusting interest rates and the money supply. When you ride a bike, you adjust the steering wheel, you adjust your weight, trying to keep the bike upright. If you don't do that, the bike falls over. The cruise control on your car, or the fuel to an airplane. I want to maintain speed by adjusting the fuel going to the engine. Another example of feedback control is the thermostat in your house. I want the temperature to stay constant in spite of the sun coming out, going behind clouds, daylight, nighttime. Temperature is supposed to stay constant. That's feedback that does that. So that's kind of what this course is all about. Controls, either process control or applied math, feedback control. So the way the course starts, we're going to start out the course with programmable logic controllers. What a PLC is it's a device that basically implements what you covered in 275 digital logic. You can turn on a pump for X seconds, turn on a fan for Y seconds based upon inputs. It's implemented using a graphical computer language called ladder logic or Pascal. An example of that is here's a stoplight. Stoplights are also oftentimes implemented with a PLC. So here's the PLC. This is ladder logic. It's a graphical computer language. With that, I can build a stoplight. So the red light turns on for 4 seconds. The yellow light's on for 4 seconds. The red light turns on for 2 seconds. Then the green light for 5 seconds, something like that. So here's green, yellow, red. I've got a stoplight controller with a graphical computer language. That's ladder logic with a PLC. So that'll be the first 3 weeks of the semester. Basically, you've had PLC programming. If you've passed 275 digital system design, you know PLCs. It's just translating what you know to a different computer language. Starting week 3, we're going to switch over to feedback. Now, with feedback, I want to stabilize the dynamic system. We'll first look at modeling. How do you come up with the dynamics of a dynamic system? And we'll look at several different systems. We'll look at a circuit. How to find the transfer function for a circuit. If I have an RC circuit, that's the heat equation. So when I have coupled first order differential equations, I get the heat equation that you can simulate in MATLAB, something kind of like this. I've got the temperature on the left going up and down, and here's how the heat propagates through the system. That's a dynamic system I can model with a differential equation or a transfer function. Once I have mass spring systems, I get coupled second-order differential equations. Coupled second-order differential equations gives you the wave equation. And I get a very different type of response if I apply a signal that launches a wave. We'll also look at the dynamics of rotational systems, like motors and gears. I'll also look at the dynamics of a DC servo motor. So that'll be the modeling part. So basically when we have our feedback control systems and I see a system, you want to know what it refers to, here's a couple systems it might refer to. Next, during week 7 to 10, we'll look at feedback. Feedback specifically with root locus plots. Now what root locus plots do is as you close the feedback loop, the root shifts. And you kind of notice that. When you learn how to ride a bike, you first fall over, eventually learn how to adjust your weight so you stay upright. The closed loop system, the behavior is changing. The closed loop system, the poles are shifting. What root locus does is it says, how do the poles shift as I adjust the gains? What's the best spot on the root locus? What's my best gain? You can also look at how to improve the system with a compensator. So we'll be looking at different types of compensators, lead, PID, come up with a compensator to meet your specs, all using root locus techniques. And we can even control systems with delays and unstable systems. During weeks 11 and 12, we'll switch over to digital control. If my controller is a microprocessor, it runs in discrete time. You know, every 10 milliseconds, I cause an interrupt. The proper way to analyze such a system is in the Z-plane. So we'll look at designing feedback controllers in the Z-plane so you can implement them in software. And finally, we'll look at frequency domain techniques. If I have a closed loop system, I've got a transfer function G of S, compensator K of S, let S go to J omega, I've got a filter. How do you design a feedback control system from a filter standpoint? And what you're going to get are very similar answers to what we had with root locus, but looking at it from a different way, and sometimes you get better insight as to what's happening. So that's where we're heading. In terms of course administration, I'm Jake Lauer. The class times are Monday, Wednesday, Friday. The lab times, the first 3 weeks with PLCs, you can check out the PLC from my office. I've got 10 you can check out. Not enough for everyone, so throughout the entire semester, you can work on the PLCs. Those are due at the end of the semester, just to give everybody a chance. If you check out a PLC, please work on those as soon as you can to get the PLC back so somebody else can use them. The rest of the homework sets, the labs are part of the homework. The textbook is Bison Academy. If you'd like an alternate textbook, like a hard copy, there are plenty of good textbooks out there. Don't worry about the edition. Again, control systems hasn't changed since the 1950s, so you know anything that has root locus in it, you're good. Buy the cheapest version. I personally like Control System Design by Bernard Friedland, but the other ones are also perfectly good textbooks. In terms of the bulletin description, this is analysis and design of control systems. Yeah, basically designing closed-loop feedback systems. The prereq is signals and systems. You need that. You need the Laplace transforms to take this course. The objective is by the end of the semester, you should be able to determine the differential equation that describes an electric circuit, mass spring system, or rotational system. I should be able to determine the transfer function of a system from its differential equation. I should be able to determine how a given system behaves by inspection based upon dominant poles. How to design a feedback control system. Or how feedback control system behaves as the feedback gains change using root locus techniques, and design a single loop control system for a dynamic system using root locus and frequency domain techniques. Now the textbook for this course is on Bison Academy. If you go to bisonacademy.com, you get the landing page for most of the courses that I teach. Click on 461 Control Systems. That takes you to the homepage for this class. What that looks like is this. It's got the course content specified on a daily basis. Under lecture, you've got the lectures in a PDF format. So if you want to read ahead of time or see what we're covering in class, this is the lecture. All lectures have been recorded and posted on YouTube. That's the videos over here. Handouts and code, if there's a handout for that day, that's under this section. And the homework assignments. Homework assignments are posted on Bison Academy. Typically, the homework is due on Monday. We'll go over it on Wednesday. When we go over it on Wednesday, I'll post the solutions both as a PDF file as well as a YouTube file. So the people taking the class online can see me going over the homework as well. Now, if you get stuck, there's also a section called Homework Sets and Solutions, the second tab. This has the homework sets and solutions from previous semesters. So if you get stuck, this is a good place to go to see how to start. I change the homework problems every semester, so you can't just copy and paste. But the solutions will be very similar. And there's only so many ways you can design feedback control systems. The procedure is the same. The actual numbers and gains will be different. In terms of how this course is offered, this course is offered in the full HyFlex mode. What that means is you can take the course any way you like. You can attend in person. You can live stream on Zoom. You can watch the YouTube videos, take the course online. How you take it is completely up to you, and it doesn't matter how you signed up for the course. If you signed up for online or in person, everybody's welcome in person. There's plenty of seats in the room. If you want to take it online for whatever reason, that's fine as well. It's your choice. Long as you can do the homework, long as you can pass the tests, I'm good. That being said, in person is better than online. I've been teaching in person for 32 years, teaching online for 3-4 years. I'm better in person than online. So given a choice, take the class online, or correction, given the choice, take the class in person. But it's really your choice. If for whatever reason in person doesn't work for you that day, live stream is an option, YouTube videos are an option, your pick. Now, in terms of the homework sets are posted on Bison Academy. They're due the following Monday, unless Monday is a holiday, then it's Wednesday, except for the PLC assignments. Those are due whenever you get them done. End of the semester is a hard deadline. A good way to do the homework is to create a Word document and copy and paste. Many of the homework assignments, you'll need to use MATLAB. What I can do is copy and paste the MATLAB code into my Word document, use the snipping tool. Do a screen capture for the images, paste that into my Word document, then submit my Word document as my homework set. You can submit the homework as a hard copy in person, as a PDF file, as a Word file, JPEG image, you know, whatever works for you, as long as I can read it. You can submit on Blackboard, email it to me. Again, long as I can get it, I don't care. The labs, there's two types of labs. The PLC labs for the first three homework sets will be using a Micro 810 PLC from Allen Bradley. Those you can check out from my office. The rest of the homework, the lab is really done in MATLAB. You'll design on paper, then check your design. A good way to check your design is to run a MATLAB code to simulate your dynamic system. And there's a couple good tools to simulate dynamic systems. There's MATLAB. Write some MATLAB code to simulate it. There's Simulink. Simulink is a graphical version of MATLAB. It lets you simulate using block diagrams. There's VisSim. VisSim is a different company. It's very similar to Simulink. I think it's much better. Just basically a graphical way to simulate dynamic systems. There's also CircuitLab. One of the features of CircuitLab is it will also simulate dynamic systems. That's a feature I haven't really played with yet, but it's available. So, however you want to check your paper design to make sure it works when you actually try it. In terms of required student resources, you're going to need a calculator that can do complex numbers. I recommend HPs. HPs are worth about 10 points on a test, in my opinion. There's the HP 35, which is $184 on Amazon. There's the Free 42. That's a free app on your cell phone that emulates the HP 42. In my opinion, the best calculator ever made, and it's free. Or you can use your TI 84 Plus. Just note that TI 84 is really struggle when it gets to complex numbers, and we do a lot of complex numbers in this class. You'll also need MATLAB. MATLAB's available on all computers in the ECE cluster. It's also free for all NDSU students, so you can use MATLAB at home. In terms of grading, this class has three midterms, homework, and a final. Each has equal weighting. Your overall average is 90% guaranteed an A, 80% guaranteed a B. I'll curve down but won't curve up. What that means is if you're working in a group on the homework, you all understand the material, all do well on the midterms, I'm happy to give out all A's. I'll have to justify that to my chairman, but if everybody can demonstrate proficiency with PLCs, modeling, design using root locus, design using frequency domain techniques, that's an A. And finally, legal stuff. Attendance is required. How you attend is up to you. You can attend in person, you can live stream, you can watch the YouTube videos, whatever works for you. Long as you can do the homework, pass the tests, I'm good. If you have any special needs, let me know, I'll accommodate them. In terms of academic honesty, the point behind that is that when you graduate, this is information you're going to need. If you can figure out a way to get through this class without learning anything, please don't. Because when you get to industry and they ask you to design a feedback control system or analyze a feedback control system and you're stuck, that doesn't show up well in industry. Our graduates design pacemakers, defibrillators, flight controllers, things like that. To do that, you need knowledge of this class. So it's better to learn it here at NDSU than wind up in industry and either design something where you have no idea how it works, which puts people's lives at risk, or you can't do your job. And if you're a veteran or a student soldier, something comes up, let me know, we'll accommodate you. So that's control systems. Again, one of my favorite classes, that's actually my major. My major is applied math control systems. A course I really enjoy, and a course that I hope you'll enjoy as well. So with that, we'll be able to move on to the first lecture.